Welcome to Salvation Temple Church, where the focus is on you. Welcome to Salvation Temple Church, where the focus is on you. Welcome to Salvation Temple Church, where the focus is on you.
I'm a good God. Hallelujah. Go ahead and be seated in Jesus' name. Woo. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We thank you for being in this morning. Happy holiday. We endeavored to put ourselves together a concise. Any of y'all got the cue going? Or your cue should be done by now. No? You got to do it fresh. Oh, okay. All right. Marinating. Okay. Well, bless you. So we're going to do our best to get out of here in good order, good time. We made the decision to have children sit in with us today. So parents, I need you to keep an eye on your children so I don't have to walk over there and smack them. Yeah. Come on now. Security in the house. Bless your darling heart. And we welcome those of you on the conference call. We'll be back together on Wednesday. Thank you for sharing in this great technology. It gives us opportunity to put our message beyond these walls and also provide the opportunity for people to see and know the truth and the anointing of God, which is alive even as we speak and share. And it stays alive on our phone conferences 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Keep checking out our YouTube channel. We're working it. We're pushing to get it to the place where it's up on Sunday evening. Even. Come on now. I said, so stretch your hands towards Aaron Hightower and make sure we get it done Sunday evening. And then plus, he had to use my iPad. And I told him yesterday, boy, you want to use my iPad on a Saturday night? Oh, we got to work on that. Amen. But y'all pray that he has, that we get this thing flowing and real good, and we can upload it as soon as the service is over. Amen. Check our website, stc.church. You can find information there and get connected to our social media sites. Let's get into the lesson for this morning.
Yes.
And I want you to appreciate this title here, the eWORD heart attack. I use that expression for the sensationalism of the heart attack. Let me see what that's about. Who wouldn't look otherwise? But to be actually truthful with you, that's what the Spirit of God unctioned on the inside of me. Heart attack. An introduction statement. It's important for us to keep knowing and keep reminding ourselves that we are fearfully, as the scriptures say, and wonderfully made, come on, by God. God made us the way he made us. And it's important for us to appreciate how he made us so that we can cooperate with the way he made us. Huh? And as we look in here together, we're going to find, and I'm going to tell you, it's important to get good understanding. See, good understanding is needed to reap the benefits of the great relationship that God made for our hearts and our lives. God made a relationship to our heart and how it impacts our lives. Now, of course, when you say heart, you have to consider that there's two kinds of heart when you're dealing with the things of God. Yes? One, of course, is that flesh pump that works in your chest. And it's just fascinating. When you see on a, what do you call that thing when you take a little picture of the baby? Ultrasound. And that little, once that bad boy gets started, that means it's going to be for 80, 90 years. Come on. Come on now. Now, yeah, we got technology that if it stops, then we do something and help it get going again. But the expectation of the journey, and God said, give us 120 years, he wants that flesh pump to work like it's supposed to work for 120 years. Come on now. And so consequently, it's important for us to appreciate, yes, God did give us a muscle, flesh pump, muscle in our chest to keep us alive, and therefore we need to cooperate with how he made it and how it's supposed to function.
Amen.
Even the flesh pump in the chest is critical. It doesn't take well to cholesterol. Come on.
Amen.
It doesn't take well to stress.
Yes.
It doesn't take well to nicotine. Come on.
Amen.
It doesn't take well to a lot of stuff we put in our bodies, and we keep wondering why. Hello? God made us in a certain way. And he gave knowledge, technology, medical insight to people that can help us have it work like it's supposed to work if we just do what they say. I said if we just do what they say. And 99% of people who have had heart issues. And, oh, yeah, we got a community health event coming up here in November where they're going to be checking out some hearts and some blood pressure. This year we're even having a cardiology mobile unit come. Hello, amen, hallelujah, glory to God. And listen, God wants your flesh pump to work well so that as he uses you in his kingdom, you can be fit for the master's use.
Yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
We had this fit business about that being mature, to grow up, to be fit, to be used. Okay, well, hey, so that part we need to keep working on. That part we need to pay attention to. And God made it. God made it. God made us the way he made us. I mean, to the extent that I had a little stone or something in one of my sandals the other day. And it was just like you couldn't do nothing. Come on now. Just a little piece of something in that sandal. And it was just like it's causing my whole body to have issues.
Yeah.
Just a little bit, something like that.
Yeah.
So it's marvelously made. It's wonderfully put together, and it becomes critically important for us to cooperate with how God made it so it can work to the fullest extent. Now, we need to connect with that second heart issue. What other heart is that? What heart is that? One is the flesh. It's your spirit. It's our spirit. The heart of us is our spirit. So, and really in a parallel kind of a way, the way to keep both of them doing well, the pattern is pretty much the same. You got to feed your flesh pump good food. Come on.
Amen.
In order for it to work. And don't be putting crazy stuff in it. Come on.
Yeah.
And stressing it all out.
Yeah.
Well, in the same way, listen to me now. In the same way, we have to feed our spirit self.
Amen.
The heart of our spirit. And the heart of our spirit needs more than Wheaties.
Yes.
Amen.
It needs more than coffee. Come on.
Wait.
I know you may think so, but your spirit heart, the best food going. Come on. You know, back in the day, they used to have small, medium, large. That was it. Then they moved into large, extra large. Then they moved into the big gulp. And then they moved into jumbo, super big, large. And people just go for it. Okay? Well, there's only one food. Come on now. Our heart, listen to me. Our heart really was made, the heart of our spirit was made to receive one food. And when you put that food in there, that spirit heart gets busy.
Yes.
Come on. That spirit heart does one of those, good. So what is that food for the spirit heart? I need everybody to open your mouth, say it out loud, because I'm not going to be up here long. I need you to participate. So what is that food that caused our spirit man to be well and strong and and have insight and wisdom and have joy and peace and strength and power and goodness, meekness, for all of those things to work well when we feed our spirit heart the Word of God? That spirit heart will do what it's supposed to do. I don't care what's going on around you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So here's, we're going to get some of this good understanding about the benefits that God created when he made us, of the relationship of how we deal with our hearts and our lives. So here's how to get it done. In the main scripture text, the first highlight point is full-time EKG. Any of you ever had one? EKG. Yeah, they put all them little sticky things and all that. And what's the one where they make you go on the treadmill and they walk you? Stress test. Lord Jesus. I remember a long time, they put me in one of them bad boys and I was kind of like, whoa! I jumped off and lady got all excited. I said, hey! You got to slow this thing down here because I'm getting ready to fall off. But anyway, so full time, and they use this EKG to check and see how it's doing what it's supposed to do. If this is opening like it's supposed to open, this is closed, like this, and this is flowing in through like it's supposed, and this is flowing in like that, and it's, the timing is right, and it's not skipping. Come on now. Because, you know, if your heart skips a beat, you get that little lightheaded thing. You ever get some of that? Some people think they ain't loving it. Heart was just out of whack. That's all. The flesh pump was out of whack. Come on. Okay. So they put this EKG to check out the heart. Well, we find in our scripture, main text scripture, Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23, it says, keep thy heart, how? With all diligence. All diligent. You got to be sure to pay good attention to what's going on. Yes, with the flesh heart, the doctors do that. But we need to be doing a full-time EKG for our spiritual heart. Come on, because you can check, you know, you don't have to put on little patches and all them too. You just lean back a little while and be honest with yourself. And you'd be amazed what your spirit heart will tell you about how you treat me. They see it on the screen. They run a little ticker tape out or whatever they do when they do the EKG. And they read the little lines and they say, oh, look at this line right here. This one did like this and this one did like that. Da, 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 da. Your heart spirit will give you the same information. Gives you better information. I said it gives you better information. And it'll tell you. You know, this little, your spirit heart said, that little squiggly line right there, that's where you didn't do that forgiveness that you needed to do. Huh? And what's that one when they call it when it just stops? Flatline. Boom! You don't care what nobody say. You don't care what nobody do. You just not gonna give in. Flatline, huh, in the realm of the spirit. Okay, so then let's read the whole verse. Proverbs chapter 4, verse number 23. Keep thy heart with all diligence. Why? For out of it are the issues of life. And God not playing there, y'all. Amen. I mean, your heart issue, your heart, whatever's in your heart in the most, your heart has an impact on the issues of your life. And we've been teaching these series about fruit of the spirit and the church is this and the church is that. And then I believe Holy Spirit helped this thing dawn on me in relationship to, it appears that there's a possibility where people can have one thing going on in their heart and a whole lot of stuff going on out here. And the stuff going on out here has such an impact on what's going on to whatever's in the heart don't matter. Huh? So then that means we have to work on making sure we have a good sense of balance between what is going on in our heart to help us deal with what's going on around us. Amen. Huh? And I'll tell you, I'm convinced, and that's the reason why I'm preaching this message here, I'm convinced that there's a lot of people overlook, they override whatever's going on in their heart because, you know, when you don't drink enough water, you get dehydrated, you get dry, you get weak. Come on. You don't eat enough food, right? Even fasting, you don't eat enough. Or you don't eat enough of the right thing. Come on, because eating a whole bunch of the wrong thing has the same impact as not eating nothing. So then when that happens, you physically get weak, don't you? When we're not feeding our spirit, I mean copious amounts of the word of God, then that heart spirit, as it were, gets weak, huh? And then our emotions can override our spirit self, and then we do something stupid. Okay, so we need this full-time EKG, checking out how the heart is working. And then if you ever get a real good friend, I mean a good friend. I don't mean, you know, associates and acquaintances and those people who are just there for what you can do, who are just there for what you can do for them. And then when you stop doing for them, they gone. But if you ever get a real good friend, of course you need to find out this EKG business from God, Holy Spirit. But you know what else? If you have a real good friend sometime, they can help you. A real good friend can help you check yourself. Huh? Because there's a lot of times, I'm telling you, on the inside of me, I don't feel the age I am on the inside. But there are other times when people looking at me, they're like, boy, you tired today? And it don't hardly matter how I feel on the inside, what I look like. Come on, you know how it is, you run out, your hair not done, or you left it on the... All right. Ah! Ah! And it'd be like, did you forget something today? So we need to keep working on this EKG. We need to keep working on making our hearts as strong as we can possibly make them, feeding them on the Word of God. I don't know. It's probably been a long time since I made reference to the incident I had back there in January. But I'm telling you. When I was laying out there in that hospital, I'm telling you, what nothing important to me but hearing the word of God. Amen. And Holy Ghost told me the other night when I was working on this lesson that the best time to deal with a physical challenge is before it happens. Yeah. It's hard to put a roof on in the rain. Come on. Huh? But it's better while it's not raining to do your roof work. Oh, I wish you'd hear me now. And the fact that God gives you a brand new day every day, and you spend that day running around doing this and running around doing that and not filling yourself up with the Word of God, my. So Holy Ghost said, you need to be doing healing scriptures now. Huh? Yeah. You know, I don't purport to try to tell you how and when and how long and all that kind of stuff. But the bottom line is, listen, at some point in your total approach to the day, every day, come on, every day. You need to be dealing with some healing scriptures. Every day. Oh, I'm strong. I'm getting better. Yeah, but you still got to keep dealing with the healing scripture. Because you build your heart spirit up so that one, it can tell you, don't put that in your mouth, at least. And then when something else comes along beyond your issue, you know, there's junk in the water, there's junk in the food, there's junk in the ground, there's junk. But when some other things come that you don't have any control over, that power in the spirit of your heart will push it off.
Amen.
So then, keep thy heart with all, not just every now and then, not just because something came up, no, all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Okay, let's move to our support text scripture. First highlight point there, to know you is to love you. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9. The heart is deceitful. Look at this. Above all things and not just wicked, desperately wicked. Come on. Who can know it? Now, on one hand, he's saying, hey, this bad boy, the whole issues of life come out of there, and you need to be diligent dealing with it. And then on the other hand, you say, hey, it's desperately wicked. It can't, who can know it? It's deceitful. You know how deceit is. Look up here at me. This is deceit. No. Yes. You know, you're saying yes with your mouth and no with your head, or no with your mouth and yes with your head, or whatever. That's deceit. Huh? And deceit has a way of smiling at you and keeping notes. It just can't wait till it gets you. Well, the heart is like that too, especially emotional, overrun flesh heart is deceitfully wicked. A deceitful flesh pump will make you think you see stuff that's not there, make you think you heard something that wasn't said, make you feel something that's not really true. So then, therefore, here's this point of the matter. To know you is to love you. And if I could put my finger on one of the major issue areas in the lives of people in church today, the bottom line is going to be they really don't believe that God actually loves them. Ways. You see it all the time. You see it everywhere. It happens all the time. It happens consistently. People doing actions that are opposite of what God declares when he says, I love you. As a matter of fact, he said, I love you so much, I sent my only begotten son to die for you. And you still want to drink that? You still want to throw that in your arm? You still want to walk around and feel like, I don't know if I care, and I just don't know what I'm going to do. And God, the creator of the universe, all heaven, God, listen, when there was nothing at all, God created.
Amen.
Huh? And then we have the audacity to have an attitude about something going on in our life. And then we start acting out. So then, number one issue is to know that God really loves you.
Amen.
I mean, really. Because to know you, God, that he loves you, is to love him, God, because he loves you. Huh? And when you love God, come on, work with me here. When you love God, there are things that you will do no matter what. And there are other things you won't do no matter what. And when you love God, you'll spend time with him. You'll learn his voice, listen to what he has to say, and then do what he tells you to do. All right, highlight point. Mouth, heart, good connection. There's a good connection. There's a wonderful connection that God made between what is in our heart and what comes out of our mouth. In the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 12, verse number 34, it says, oh, generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So don't fool yourself. Don't fool yourself. Whatever somebody said that was in their heart the most, I don't care what they look, I don't care how they smile, I don't care how much they say, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. Yes, you did. And by the same token, when you listen to your own mouth, it's going to tell you what's in your heart the most. Marvelous connection. And we don't have to have a lot of confusion or being ambivalent, you know, not being able to decide what's going on. No, whatever you're saying is a major indication of what's in your heart. And nobody put that in your heart but you. That door on that heart is your door. You can keep it closed. You don't have to accept anything. Come on now. As a matter of fact, in a more powerful way, you shouldn't accept just anything into your heart from anywhere. Come on now. Because whatever's in there the most, and it's going to impact the issues of your life. Verse 35 of the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 12, it says, a good man out of the good treasure of the heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. Being, it's either one or the other. And we have the powerful opportunity to make sure we have good things in our heart so that it will bring forth good things. Now, I'm doing condensed, so I got to go on. Well, I'll ask it like this. So how do you get good things in your heart? Feeding it from the word. See, y'all sitting over there, y'all just looking at me. I need you to just work your lips, you know, just act like you're saying something if you're not. Where do you get good things to put into your heart? Feeding it, yeah, from the word of God. I don't know how many times we have to keep saying this, but listen, out of the abundance of your mouth, I've been hearing a whole lot of junk. In the actions that I see, in the things that I know, there's some anemia going on somewhere. There's some. What do you call that thing when your heart is on? Which is just not working. Life support. Boom. I mean, if the music wasn't pumping, come on. Some people just fall off the chair and die. If we didn't force some people to read the word of God, they'd fall off the chair and die. Life support. And brother and sister, these things ought not be. We don't have to keep struggling what we're struggling with. We don't have to keep putting up with what we're putting up with. The answer is in putting a good word into your heart. And don't back up for no reason at all. Okay, Fort Knox heart, Fort Knox heart. The Gospel according to Luke chapter 6. Y'all know, I don't know what some school systems be teaching sometimes. So any young people in here, you guys over there, Josh and Caleb and who else is that? Is that your friend? Hi, friend. Okay. What is Fort Knox? Do y'all know what Fort Knox is? Fort Knox? Cece, what's Fort Knox? You don't know. You a girl? What's his names back here? And Gia and Jemima. And Zuri. What is Fort Knox? See, our school system, listen, our school system got some work to do. That's some adults. Who said, how many adults don't know? You don't know? You're an adult and you don't know? Oh, they, now they ain't going to hold up their hand now. They never hold their hand now. Fort Knox, especially women ought to know. Gold, no, not just money, gold. Gold, gold. Fort Knox is the place in Kentucky. Is it Kentucky? Where all the gold, supposedly, all the gold of the country is kept in Fort Knox. That's an important, Fort Knox has so much gold in it that it's supposed to be able to keep things going from now on. Except we got this $20 trillion debt, something like that. But okay, so Fort Knox is an important place. It's a powerful place. It's a very necessary place. It is a well-guarded place. This, now, anybody just be going into Fort Knox and all kinds of stuff. Don't have no planes flying over Fort Knox and dust on this and that. So then, I'm saying that it's a really, really important place where good treasure is kept. So then in the Gospel according to Luke chapter 6, verse number 45, it says, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So I think I'm trying to say to us, so let's get our hearts filled up, huh? With the gold that's in the Word of God. I mean, when you hear that, I will never leave you, come on, or forsake you. That's like a big bullion bar of gold, huh? Huh? And it's locked up, it's kept there. And whenever you need it, it's right there. And you can go and make decisions and you can make determinations on the fact that God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And that other gold bullion that says it is the Father's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. So we need to check out the good treasure. We need to recognize our heart is a place to have deposit, to contain the good golden Word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So here's our teaching point. Teaching point. We have a blessed opportunity to have more solid lives once we become better managers of our heart actions. Remember I said a little while ago, the door of your heart, the door of your spiritual heart, nobody has a key to that. But you. Now, you let the key out, you give the combination up, and anybody come in your heart with any old kind of thing, and you just have to deal with it. Otherwise, you manage what comes in that heart. You make a special point to put in that heart those things that will cause the issues of your life to be more consistent with the joy, come on, with the peace, with the patience, with the goodness that you deserve. Now, the flesh part of me is wanting to say, so that means you need to quit putting up with certain things. Huh. Okay, teaching point. We have a blessed opportunity to have a more solid lives when we become better managers of our heart actions. And it's easy to manage a good heart. It's easy. Oh, listen, it's no sweat. When your heart is good, filled up with the good word, it's no sweat to be able to say, oh, I forgive you, man. Go on about your business. No mention. Don't think about it no more. I'm through. I'm free. You free? Go ahead. It's easy to do that when your heart's got a good treasure. It's easy. You know, we struggle when we hear this verse, blessed, pray for those who despitefully use you, you know, bless and curse not, do good to them who misuse you and all that kind. Oh, how can you do that? Out of the good treasure of a good heart.
Amen.
Amen. When you know that God loves you and whatever anybody took from you, God will restore it beyond anything that you can imagine.
Yes.
Okay. Last action point now. So here's some things we need to do. Action point. The power of putting good things in our heart is vital. In our hearts is vital. And it's vital for having good balance between who we are and what we believe about ourselves. Because that's an area right there where a lot of people struggle. But you know, I like me. I am okay with me. And I, listen, now please understand this. I'm your pastor. I love you. But I could care less about what you think. I know God loves me. His hand, listen, he saved me. And I can't let little rattly mouth of what somebody else say make me say, oh, you ain't saved. Or you ain't a good pastor. You're bump. Because I know my heart. Listen, my heart will give you the shirt off my back. My heart will run into the cupboard and pull food out just for you. I will drive all the way across the town just to get you, help you. Amen. And you let somebody tell you, well, you ain't nothing. Oh, he hurt my feelings. Shut up. Shouldn't have had your feelings out there in the first place. Counting on somebody to love you. You better let God love you. Okay, all right. We're doing good. But settle in on what you believe about yourself now.
Amen.
Settle in. And when you decide that you're God's child, when you decide God is your heavenly father, it don't matter what other people think. It don't matter what other people do. God will be not dismayed. Whatever be tied, God will take care of you. Okay. Determination point, and then I'm out of here. Consistent heart checking will go a long way for preventing heart attacks from making our lives ineffective. So right here, I want to take just a minute to say, well, what are some of the heart attacks? What are some heart attacks? Heart attacks happens when your heart doesn't receive the proper blood. You know, there might be a clog in there somewhere in the way. Unforgiveness is a clog. Fear is a clog. Make a heart attack. Fear will make you take a good friend and turn them off and never talk to them anymore. Somebody who stuck with you through thick and thin. Some heart attack, some clog. In some say, somebody said, they said, who said what? Or you thought you saw a look, you thought you heard a certain thing, blah, blah, heart attack. Yes. Destroy a relationship, destroy your life, destroy your family. But if you consistently keep checking that heart out, do that EKG, then when things come up, you'll know how to handle them. Last determination point, keep the love of God in full measure in our hearts. I'm telling you, we need to know that God loves us. We really do. So I'm going to ask you this. This is a little test, and I just want you to hold up your hand. I'm telling you in advance, hold up your hand. Do you really know that God loves you? Hold up your hand. Okay? And then that makes me want to say, well, then you need to start acting like it. Start talking like it. Start living like it. Walk around looking like your daddy owns the whole world. Because he does. Come on now. And don't let fear about this or fear about that cause you to get nervous and uneasy. God knows what he's doing. Listen, God knows what he's doing with you. He has a plan for your life. He's already laid it out. He knows the end from the beginning of his plan for your life, and nothing at all can disrupt that. Amen. Stand up on your feet. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Isn't Jesus wonderful? I know God loves me. I need you to say that loud. I know God loves me. Lift up your hand and say, thank you, Father, for your great love. Fill up my heart with your word. Teach me to fill my heart with your word. And I will be a doer of your word. And you cause the results to come to pass in my life. In Jesus' name. Make me good treasure. To be a blessing. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to take this time now to share with you the gospel. Well, we say this practically every Sunday. We say it over and over and over and over again. And I'm praying and believing God that it will pierce through every issue, every situation, every circumstance in your life and continue to demonstrate its great power in your life. In Jesus' name. The gospel is found in the gospel according to John chapter 3, verse number 16. The words are there on the screen. Would you take a moment? Let's read it together out loud. Ready? Read. For God. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. What happened? Uh-huh. And this gospel is a marvelous beacon. It's a light. It's a pointer. It's like a weather vane to show us the direction to salvation. Salvation is found in Romans chapter 10, verse number 9. And there's other verses, but we use this for purpose of illustration. That verse is going to be up on the screen. I need you to read it together out loud. Ready? Read. That's it. What happened? Uh-huh. Yes, he did. Saved, saved, saved. That means you're not going to perish. That means that you're not going to lose. That means that that means you're not going to go to hell. Yes. Amen. Thou shalt be saved. Let's pray this prayer together out loud. Say, God in heaven, thank you for today. I want to tell you again that I believe your great love for me is true. So as I walk through life, help me walk in your love. Help me receive your love. Help me consider your love in every circumstance, in every situation. Thank you for being the lover of my soul. I receive Jesus as my Savior, my Master. I make Jesus the Lord of my life. Whatever he tells me, I will do. Wherever he leads me, I will go. And whatever he has for me belongs to me. And I thank you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Well, you pray that prayer, you believe that, then you're born again. Find yourself a good church. Get into the Word of God. You heard this out of this whole message, how critical it is to get the Word of God into the heart of your spirit.
Thank you for tuning in to the Salvation Temple broadcast. We'd like to invite you to our weekly services, Sunday mornings at 10:45 a.m. and Wednesday evenings at 6:45 p.m. Or join us for our conference call by dialing 530-881-1212 and entering the access code. We look forward to seeing you at Salvation Temple Church, where the focus is on you.